Hello. This video is a little tour of the Gaffney Residence Organ, and we hope you might enjoy hearing some of the sounds of this rather interesting instrument, which is much of a hodgepodge. We begin with the great division. I'll tell you a little bit about most of the stops, and you'll get to hear them singly and in ensemble. First is the 8-foot great principal, and it is built by M.P. Moeller from vintage 1952, and has a pretty broad sound. Sounds like this. It's combined with an M.P. Moeller 4-foot octave, vintage 1969. Two-foot 15th of the same vintage. And capped by a 1969 Moeller 3-rank mixture. Present here also is an 8-foot Moeller Gedeckt, a 1952, and a Moeller 4-foot Prestant, 1969. And when added to the ensembles, these fill the grade out very nicely. I'll add it as I play. And we can add a small reed chorus in the form of an 8-foot fagot and its 16-foot extension contrafagot. And for a large chorus reed, we have a chorus bombard, M.P. Moeller, 1969. A 16-foot flute stop. Rather large sound on the great. The great 8-foot flutes, 8-foot Gedeckt, M.P. Moeller, 1952. Combined with a hook and Hastings 4-foot roar flute. And with a 2-foot roar flute, same year, same manufacturer. Lovely, leaving out the 4-foot pitch. And of course, the great has the inevitable set of chimes. Moving along to the positive division, which on this instrument is played from the lowest manual. The positive here is basically an orchestral slash positive. So let's first hear the traditional positive sounds. 1969 Moeller large Chiffy Holzgedeckt. With a copper float added. Two-foot block float, same vintage, same builder. Add a 4-foot principal. Two and two-thirds in Zard. then, of course, it has a lovely cornet. So. One of the nice stops on this division is an 8-foot regal, builder unknown, was rebuilt for me by the Tribo Company of Hagerstown. And I particularly like this stop when it's combined. When it's combined with the 4-foot gross roar flute. And perhaps even the 2 2/3 mutation. Exploring the orchestral side of this division, there is a keen 8-foot gamba. With its celeste. And an interesting feature of this organ, unusual but certainly not unheard of, is an 8-foot solitional. But with an added two ranks, one playing flat and the other playing sharp. Unusual here is, excuse me, an independent 4-foot celeste, which is designed to set on top of the 3-rank celeste. And of course combines very well when you add the big gamba celeste. And adding the inevitable vox humana. As I mentioned before, gross roar flute at 4-foot, MP Moeller. Goes very well with the 8-foot Holzgedeckt. Add the 2-foot block flute and get a rather different sound from the posting flutes. Lovely little oboe here. And to make the organ a bit more flexible, we have the romantic chorus, which pulls basically all the larger scaled 8-foot stops on the organ. And then one can add the celestes on the postive orchestral. Vox humana. Moving along, the choir division, which is played from the fourth manual on this instrument, begins with the inevitable, almost inevitable, 8-foot dulciana. With its Undamaris Celeste. I should mention that all the Celeste stops on this instrument go down all 61 notes, so they actually go down to low C. On top of this Dulciana and Undamaris, there's a very small 4-foot Fugere, which adds a nice shimmer to the sound. A flute celeste is also available in this division. Combines nicely with the strings. And to it may be added our cornet de viol. Add a little weight to it, add the 8-foot Goggin Principle. For a very stringy sound. This division also features a lovely Roosevelt clarinet. Which blends well with a 4-foot doppelflute and tremolo. The flute chorus here consists of a melodia, an open flute, your choice of a 4-foot doppelflute, or a 4-foot triangle flute. Doppelflute much brighter. Triangle flute almost has a principal-like sound. All of this can be capped by a 2-foot Gemshorn. Or with the doppelflute as the 4-foot. Or with both. Rather nice sound for accompanying a choir. Principal chorus here, Goggin Principal, which you heard a moment ago, M.P. Moeller, 1907. Four-foot Principal, M.P. Moeller, we believe in the 1940s, late 1940s. And with the 2-foot Gemshorn. Capped off by a 2-rang zimbal. Sesquioctaver is available here. And it sounds like this. It is M.P. Moeller, 1969. And then finally, we have a reed course consisting of a 8-foot trompet, M.P. Moeller, 1950s. It's 16-foot. And a 4-foot Chalmai Moeller, the same vintage. So if we add this to the entire choir chorus, we come up with something that sounds like this. Moving on to the bombard division, which is on the fifth manual, we have a tromba built by Laukoff in the 1980s. In the organ from which this stop came, that was the only reed on the organ, which was somewhat interesting because it was unenclosed and made sort of a large sound for a small instrument. And it has a 16-foot counterpart. Our high pressure 12-inch, which is high for this organ, tuba mirabilis. Spanish sounding 1940s Moeller trompet. It sounds a bit like Antonio Soler. And then there's an English horn here, which is quite lovely, especially with the tremolo. There's also a large reed called the processional bombard, somewhat between a tuba and a trombone. And if we play the entire chorus of the bombard together, stop, which is called curiously Conquering Ranks Combined, combines all the 8-foot reeds in the organ with the bombard. Makes for a rather grand sound. Moving on to the swell division. The swell division has Celeste, Solitional and Celeste, M.P. Moeller, 1969. And an interesting addition to this is these stops are here as draws, and they may play both the Celeste and the Solitional at 4, and they have an extension to take them all the way up to the top of the compass. Acts sort of as a dedicated super coupler. Rather nice sound. The swell has its own vox humana. And swell flute chorus, a clarabella, Hook and Hastings, early 1900s. Doppel float, Moeller, same vintage. Which needs tuning. And a Hook and Hastings harmonic octavin. The principal chorus here is 8 foot diapason, MP Moeller, roughly 1907. I'm sorry, that's Hook and Hastings. This the octave is MP Moeller, around 1907. The harmonic octavin we mentioned before. Larico, Alaukoff, 1980s. MP Moeller Plan Jeu, 1969. The reeds. MP Moeller 1940s harmonic trumpet with its full length extension. And a harmonic clarion. Combined with the swell flute chorus, you have a full swell that sounds something like this. And add a 16-foot flue. And then, present here, little oboe, which is very pretty. Can be used with the tremolo. One of my favorite effects is to combine this with the 4 foot doppelflute. Out of sight, but nonetheless still here, is a stop that we called the horn de sur, and it's arranged in a spiral pattern to accommodate it in the corner over in the room behind me, and it's used to provide sort of a horn sound for the swell, a little bit stronger solo sound than the oboe, and a little bit different in timbre. Finally, the swell, one of my favorite stops on the swell is actually synthetic. It's a wired sesquialtro which can be used with the 8 foot clarabella or the 8 foot doppelflute. And there are tracks located here. We have a very nice glockenspiel. And a xylophone. Combined. And then finally, we have the pedal division of the organ, and it consists of one of the prides of this organ, 16-foot open wood, Austin, 1903. With its 8-foot octave, choral bass can be added. Rank mixture molar 69. Other 16 foots would include a large Borden, an even larger Borden called a Holtzapfel, which is named after a stop on the Pennsylvania Turnpike. When you put all these 16 together, and then there are mutations here, 10 2/3, 6 2/5, and 5 1/3, and they of course give a rumble. The only non-acoustic stops, digital stops on this organ, are the two 12-note extensions, one of the 16-foot Borden, and it breaks at this pipe into at this point into digital, and the extension of the 32-foot Liebliche dactyl over 12 notes. And so forth. The pedal reeds include a bombard unit, 16, also 16-foot reeds available from the manuals. Our millennial bombard, which is much softer and has more harmonic development than the regular bombard. And then from the manuals, the contratromba, contrafagot, double trumpet from the swell, and contratrompet from the choir. So if you play the pedal division all together, you get a rather ponderous sound that sounds like this. Effect can be achieved very nicely here by using the strings. This just gives you an idea of some of the ensemble effects. Larger string effect can be achieved this way. full principal chorus sounds thus. With the small reeds, it would sound something like this. The full organ would sound a bit like this. Let me know, and I would love to have you come in and play the organ yourself and enjoy the sounds that it produces. Thank you for listening.